r/AskReddit. What do you own a ridiculous amount of? Cables. There is an unwritten law of the universe. If you throw away a cable, you will need it within a month. Similar to the law that you'll always see random objects just laying around until you actually need them. Then they're nowhere to be found. Oh, and if you purchase a replacement, guess what you can suddenly find? That the replacement is the only one out of stock. Empty boxes from ordering stuff. I'm taking them to recycling as soon as I decide I'm not gonna use them. I was so bad with boxes, and with three people in one house we were getting a lot of boxes built up. I finally got rid of them all, broke them down and recycled them. Then I had no boxes to wrap anything in for Christmas and had to buy boxes. The box cycle is a savage and heartless one. Books. I'm never moving again. IDK how you can donate them, sell them, and give them away and somehow the shelves never get more space. Kindle, and similars, were a godsend. I can finally open up shelf space and still have 1 or 8 many books to ever read in a single lifetime. Now my shelf only had the pretty books. Regrets. Felt that. Steam games. Same. 80% of which I've never played. I discovered that you can make a dynamic collection that holds only the games you never played. It's been much easier to take that number down to 79% with it. Crafting supplies. I'm a serial crafter in that I like to get really into a crafting hobby for a period of time. Could be months, years, or sometimes just weeks. And then I move on to the next craft. I usually buy supplies for that hobby as though it will be a lifelong passion. I'm also an aspirational crafter. I'll see the potential in raw materials which forces me to buy said raw materials. But then I get lazy and the project never comes to fruition. In short, I have two separate hobbies. Collecting crafting supplies and crafting. Same exact answer here. It doesn't help that I work at a craft store so I see other people's crafts. Get inspired. Tell myself my discount makes it worth it and my depression won't stop me from doing anything creative when I get home. Yet here I am with so many unfinished projects. I still have a little piece of the inspiration for them. I just have to get around to the motivation part. Plastic bags from the grocery store. I use them for trash bags in the bathroom. I do this too. I save the Walmart bags because they are gray and match the bathroom decor better than the white or brown bags. I call them fashion bags. Records. About 2,000 of them. Back in the 1980s all my friends gave me their records when they bought CDs. Toilet paper. We moved during the pandemic and everyone thought they'd be clever and send us a pack as a housewarming gift. The first couple were helpful and appreciated. The many others that followed were not. We haven't bought toilet paper since May and we still have 70 plus rolls left. We couldn't finish unpacking a few boxes because an entire closet is filled with toilet paper. At least they don't go bad. You'll eventually use them all. Paper clips. I have a whole drawer full of them. Where do they even come from? Guitar picks. I have so many because I keep losing them. So I buy more. Then I clean my couch and find all the old ones. Except the ones that the pick demon sucks into the vortex along with all the missing socks. Debt. Salt and pepper shakers. I guess 7 pairs isn't ridiculous for some niche collector but I am not. But where the hell did they all come from? I have cows, sugar skulls, goats. I don't need to shake that much salt and pepper. My mom used to have a large collection. I'm talking shelves full of those duckers. We'd occasionally swap the boring ones from the table with a fun set. But they were mostly just on display. Rice. I must own millions. Possibly billions of grains of rice. It's really great for when you're hungry and want 2,000 of something. Stringed instruments. 10 guitars. 2 basses. 2 banjos. A mandolin and a few oddballs. The real question is if you own mayonnaise. Blood sugar. Bionicle sets. They take up a good 1/2 of my personal storage space. I miss Bionicle so much. Unfortunately all the stuff from my childhood is so hard to find they go for silly money these days. Polyhedral dice. No such thing as a ridiculous amount of shiny click-clacks. Back hair. Moomin tea mugs. I have close to 60. All different. My mother gifted me them for years in my advent calendar and she got a bit carried away. Dresses. I have over 100 dresses. All were purchased from thrift shops, and all are donated back again after I wear them a few times, but still, it's a strange obsession. Coffee beans. I won a lifetime supply of gourmet coffee beans in a contest. Several pounds arrive each month. Faster than I can use them. Some get stored in the freezer, while other bags are given to friends who can use them. Wet ties. I'm a woman married to a woman and there has never been a shortage of hair ties at my house. I'm in the opposite boat. I'm a woman with two daughters and I feel like we are always searching for hair ties despite having bought a 100 pack yesterday. Where do they go? Nuts and bolts. Every time I get a new thing that needs assembled, I keep the leftovers just in case. Now I have a ton of random, particular nuts and bolts with severely limited applications and I just can't seem to throw them away. Chapstick and lip gloss. No matter where I am, there's always at least 10 somewhere around me. Clamps. You can never have too many clamps. Rocks. I have them in my purse, in my car, in my cabinets, stashed in every room of my house. I like rocks. Magic cards. Warhammer 40k armies. My wife hates that I started a hobby with lots of small pieces a few months before having our first child. Children. I know I have a shopping problem. Shoes. I just ducking love shoes. I wear a women's US 8, which is pretty common, so I can lend fancy pairs to friends who need them for a special occasion. I've given away many pairs to women who need them for part of a work uniform. I go through my collection once a year and donate the ones I never wore or don't care for anymore. Someone will love them. Guaranteed. And while I do own high quality shoes for work and Midwestern winter, most of them are just cheap, cute pairs I don't feel bad about only wearing once to go with an outfit or just because I need a shoe related self-esteem boost. I own one purse, dress very plainly, and my awesome shoes are always the highlight of my outfit. Fancy men's boxers. Used to work for Saks and always took home any samples or extra stock that was available. The rest of the staff stopped taking them when they had enough, but I kept loading up knowing I wouldn't work there forever. 5 years later, I have a suitcase in my closet with about $2,000 worth of underwear I'm planning on making last for the rest of my life, or if I ever reach the point that I can afford to pay $30 for a pair of boxers. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.